most of India's foreign direct investment inflows are not helping Modi's Make in India initiative. And why is that? Because these FDI inflows are instead helping Indian corporates get rid of their distressed assets. Now, these are assets which are put out on sale because the owners of the company are forced to sell it. This forced stake sale happens in the case of bankruptcy, increasing debt, or regulatory constraints. In 2016, 48% of the total FDI inflows that came into India went into brownfield projects. These are projects which already exist, need an upgrade or modification essentially after an acquisition. But what Modi needs are greenfield projects. These are projects that need setting up from scratch and fresh investments. In January to March of 2017, 36% of the total $7.6 billion that came into India went into buying distressed assets of big Indian corporates, which means more than a third of the total FDI that came into India came as acquisitions without creating any new jobs or any fresh investments. Here's a chart that shows how FDI inflows in brownfield projects increased twofold from 2015 to 2016. So why is this happening?
These are companies that the top 40-50 corporate groups in India have not been able to pay back the bank loans, and some of them owe banks 1 lakh crore, SR Group 1 lakh crore. Therefore, SR Group is selling its oil refinery to a Russian company for $13 billion. So now this is what you call investment in a brownfield project in the form of an acquisition of a distressed asset. So this does not create fresh investment or fresh factory or fresh employment. I wouldn't say that it is something to be greatly to be proud of. I would be happy if fresh investments come in the form of Make in India to fund Make in India projects. I would regard that as a much more productive, much more employment producing capital.
Like the SR Oil stake sale to the Russia's Rosneft-led consortium, Anil Ambani's Reliance Infrastructure also sold 49% of its stake to a Canada-based firm because of mounting debts. While brownfield FDI will help banks reduce NPAs and distressed assets in Indian corporates will come down, Modi's Make in India dream still remains unfulfilled.